5 minutes each. Once again, we are graced with the presence of the Pancrase Black Girls. Here comes the challenger, Mina Gusander. She comes here from Finland. She's 27 years old, 5'4", 114 pounds, with a 64-inch reach. Her record stands in MMA at 2-0. She hasn't tasted defeat yet.
Right, that's her professional record, and she's also the 2015 IMMAF Women's Champion.
I heard that after her next fight, she's going to be going for a title belt as well in another organization.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's definitely earned a spot in the tonight.
It's going to be an interesting fight. Probably the hardest fight that Siri Kondo has ever had up until this point.
I think so.
She's there with her coach. I had a chance to speak with both of them yesterday at the weigh-ins. Very nice people, very focused, ready for this fight.
Right. So interesting, she's also a mother of two children.
That's right. Can you imagine career day at those kids' school? What does your mom do?
Yeah. She beats people up for a living.
Cage fighter.
Yeah. Sana looks ready. She doesn't look like an amateur at all. She looks like she's really used to this this atmosphere.
She is in her world right now.
There you go.
Yeah. And coming down the warrior's path right now, Siri Kondo. She's 27 years old, 5'4", 115 pounds, with a 66-inch arm reach. Her record at MMA stands at 3-0 at this point.
Right, but she has way more experience than that. She's a professional wrestling champion and also a kickboxing champion. As you can see, she fights at a Boss Gym, which is known for having a lot of tough stand-up kickboxers.
That's right. She's got a huge following from her days as a kickboxer and her days as a pro wrestler.
That's right.
Yeah. So she's a big star here in Pancrase.
Yeah, so it's really cool to have the women's strawweight division be the main event for tonight.
Well, every time that Shuri shows up, she brings with her entire game. She brings the kickboxing, she brings the wrestling, and she never, ever, ever disappoints.
That's right. And tonight she has a really good opponent, Mina Gusander, who's a proven tough fighter as well.
Get checked out by the ref. He'll apply some Vaseline to her face and then send her into the cage where these two women will go to war. This is our main event of the evening, Curtis.
Get ready, folks.
Yeah. This fight is going to be 3 5-minute rounds if it goes all the way.
There you go. Yeah. Here we have a referee Wada putting on the Vaseline.
Makes her way into the cage. She is also in her world right now. She's born and raised to fight.
Yeah.
In the blue corner you have Mina Gusander from Finland.
赤コーナー
152.3 determination in both women's eyes.
Round one.
Here we go. Starts off round one.
It's a good strong stance from both opponents, both fighters.
Just feeling each other out. Oh, right. First contact is by... is by Grisander. A couple good exchanges right there.
Wow.
Oh, nice overhand. Quite shooty.
Right. And a really strong one. But Grisander seems to still be in it.
Grisander's still in it. She's still throwing hard shots.
She lands another straight right and a jab as well. Grisander not backing down at all. Oh, there's a nice in and out. Nice footwork from Grisander. Oh, and she eats a big right hand from Shudi again.
That front lead hand dropped a little bit and she paid for it.
That's right. It's a high level kickboxing match. Kono landing that straight right hand again. Finding a hole from that straight right hand punch. Grisander's got to do something about it. She got to keep that left hand just a little bit higher.
Yeah. Because she's going just over the top of her glove.
Yeah.
You know, just shooting it over and dropping it in at the last second.
And Kono doing a good job here of mixing it up now, pushing Grisander against the cage, permitting a bit of the wrestling, testing out Grisander's
wrestling game. Yeah.
Right. Yeah. See if she's as all-rounded as Kono is.
Kono with the underhooks there. Mm-hmm. Grisander with the wizard.
So not really able to do anything right here. Referee breaks it up.
Sends it back to the center of the cage.
Good call, I think. Kono looks a little more relaxed. A little more... Ooh, that's another right straight hand from Grisander. Into Grisander. Grisander keeps walking forward. Eats a lot of those big straight punches from Kono. There's just not enough head movement from Grisander.
Is one of them bleeding right now? I think it's Grisander bleeding.
Yeah, I see her rubbing her nose right there.
Yeah, a little bit of blood from the nose. Yeah.
She's staying really strong. Still staying active.
Yep. Still looking strong.
Yeah, just one thing. She's lacking that head movement, which is making it easy for Kono to land the straight jab and straight punches.
That's right. She needs to get the head movement going and get on those toes.
Kono trying to find a home for that jab again. Just misses it. Grisander changing it up herself.
Nice, changing levels.
Goes back up, lands her right hand. Pretty slick.
Watch your neck. Yeah, be careful for your neck. Yeah.
Should be threatening that guillotine.
Yeah.
Not there, but looks like she might have Grisander's head locked up.
She might be able to slip out, I'm not sure though.
Yeah, no.
Hair makes a difference.
Yeah, it doesn't look tight at all, but she could tighten it. We'll see.
Kono throwing some knees. Into the midsection of Grisander.
Looks like she has a better control of Grisander's head. She doesn't need it for the choke anymore, she's going for the knees. Let's see if Grisander is looking for that leg trip. I'm not sure if she has the leverage for it right now. She needs to get that head out, or at least. Again, good break by the referee. You know, you saw him kind of a non-action on both sides. He didn't really bother to wait to see what happens.
He warned him a couple times, and he's like, "No, I'm just sitting back in the middle." Right.
Again, nice jab from Shudi. And his right hand. Grisander had a combination. Her hands dropped down just a little bit too low for Nice 1-2 from Shudi. Grisander faking low again. Good idea. And we see in this matchup how Kono is putting Grisander against the cage.
Yeah.
But Grisander, she did a good job right there, like moving out to circling to her left. Try to get towards the middle.
Yeah. Not letting her stop your cage. Grisander's throwing some good punches here.
Yeah.
Good combinations.
Sometimes your best defense is a good offense.
Yes.
So we'll hear over and over again. Shudi Kono, aggressive. Not willing to back down.
And Grisander's still hanging in there with her. That's 10 seconds left.
Make this a very interesting fight.
Ooh. Good combination at the end from Gusander, but Kano, really good defense.
Yes. Both girls, excuse me, both women are really, really showing their mettle here. A bunch of good combinations.
Jeremy, so, there are no girls here.
Maybe just me.
Yeah, just kidding. Yeah. No, I'm just messing up. No, very tough. A lot of respect for these fighters.
Oh, absolutely.
Big straight
respect,
hand
yeah.
right here from Kondo.
She's taking a little bit of damage,
right.
but her nose is not broken.
Yeah.
Which I saw that little bit of blood coming out, and I thought, possibly a break there, but not the case.
Which could happen because she's eating a lot of those straight punches right over the top of her head. Right over the nose.
Open scoring gives that first round over to Shuri. All right, both fighters back into the center of the cage.
Yeah, I really like Shuri Kondo's stance and her guard.
She's a kickboxing
yeah.
champion.
Yeah.
She knows what it takes to become a champion.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, nice jab. Her corner saying, oh, she's feeling it. It's hurting her. Yeah, that jab is really, really effective. Rusano doing a good job of throwing that.
The jab overhand right. Yeah, jab overhand right combination is really working for Kondo. Yeah.
She stops a straight right hand from Rusano.
Good midsection kick by Rusano. Right again. Gusana goes for the takedown. It's stuffed by Shuri.
A good idea from Gusana, though, trying to change it up.
Tie her up, yeah. Quit eating those punches. Yeah.
Trying to implement a different strategy.
Yeah.
Using different tools.
Switching levels.
Mm-hmm. Here, good head positioning from Gusana. Try to keep Kondo pressed against the cage. She's either got to use that right hand to open up and do some dirty boxing, get some points that way. Well, she's got to drop down on those legs around the top of her thighs, maybe get a takedown.
That's a very good call. She can't stay there and just eat those knees either.
Yeah.
That doesn't help.
But Shuri has kind of a really shallow wizard, which makes it hard for Busan to drop down to get that double leg takedown.
Yeah.
Oh, now she's got the head control. Putting her type of a body lock.
She's under that.
Oh, it looks like
yeah. She's under. Oh, okay, she popped.
Looks like she had the head and the arm.
That's what I thought too.
Yeah. Ooh, nice knee to the body from Shuri Kondo. Rusana answers one back and then eats an elbow from Kondo.
Kondo's stalking Rusander.
Right.
Kondo's taking the center of the cage, the middle of the cage,
right.
and owning it.
Yeah, she is. She's doing a good job at cutting off, trying to create angles. Rusander landing a couple good punches there.
Yeah.
Staying alive. All it takes is one good punch.
There's that combination again that we were talking about.
That's right. Both fighters exchanging punches, exchanging blows. Good block, good counter punch from Gusander there. There, yeah, that's a good counter.
Shuri looking for that next shot.
Right, she got it. She got that jab.
Yeah.
Gusander, not quite the reach that Kondo has.
Yeah. Is that overhand right again?
Right.
Yeah.
Kondo's doing a really good job of keeping her distance.
Actually, this is the most boxing I've seen out of Kondo. Usually she will lock up when wrestle.
That's true.
Most of her all of her fights, her last three fights, have all been won by wrestling.
That's right. Yeah.
I'm impressed with her boxing.
Well, it just shows how well-rounded she is as a fighter.
Cassandra with her back against the cage door, looking for a chance to move herself or circle Shudi around.
Shudi Kano with the unhook.
The judge resets him and puts it back in the center. A little bit of blood coming from the nose of Grisander.
Looks like it's not enough to bother too much. But she is taking some damage in those jabs and straight jabs. And she keeps walking right into that jab. Which means Kano's doing a really good job at timing her.
30 seconds left in this round.
Another big straight from Kondo. Grisander steps in.
Oh, she gets the takedown.
Kondo against the cage.
Kondo back up. Oh, Grisander with some good shots there.
Yes, indeed. But again, Kondo putting her... Grisander putting her own head down.
Yep. Let's see in that round.
That was a good finish for Grisander at the end of that round.
Yes.
Nice takedown. Was able to land some blows in there. Even though Shudi did.
Let's check out the replay.
Yep.
There's that overhand right we're talking about.
And that's and that jab we've been seeing all night long. Yeah. But
there it is again. Yeah.
And watch Grisander's takedown attempt. Now let's see. But yeah, this is the story of the night tonight in this fight.
Yeah. Okay, the open scoring has given that round. All three judges have given that round to Shudi Kano.
Kano's face looking pretty clean. And on the landing, Grisander looks visibly swollen.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are heading into our final round. Final round for the main event.
Right. With Grisander down by 2 points, she needs to do something drastic to turn the tide of this match. She looks like she's still in there.
She's a very, very tough competitor.
Yes, she is. Kano winning, but not able to break Grisander down yet.
Not yet. Yeah. So the first two rounds have gone to Kondo, so Grisander, her only chance to win this fight is by KO.
So right here, Grisander's doing a good job at using her arm block right now and countering with that left hook. She did two times in a row already. So maybe her coaches said something about keep your hands up a little more. Let's use that arm block a little bit more. But that jab went through again.
Both fighters are trying to stay in the center of that cage and control this match.
Right. Again, nice takedown attempt.
Goes for his takedown attempt.
But Shudi defends. He has that whizzer in there again.
Shudi Kondo with her back against the cage. Grisander putting on the pressure. Throwing in some knees.
Right. Kondo's doing a good job of getting that, keeping that whizzer and going for that underhook with the left arm. So it pretty much makes it impossible for Grisander to drop down to get that double leg takedown. So she needs to change her strategy right here.
Yeah.
Either do something up top, go for a technique up top.
Or the referee will reset them. That's what I'm thinking is going
to
happen.
And her head's a little bit too low to land any dirty boxing. She needs to get her head on the other side of Kano's face and open up her right hand to land the big right hand punches against the cage.
And she can go for try to trip her here by hooking that back leg around. That's an option as well.
That's right. That's right. Yeah. And on the other hand, too, like with that whizzer, Kondo could go for a judo throw there.
Definitely.
Lots of options. So MMA is so interesting.
All right, back to the center of the cage.
Corner's yelling 3 minutes. Kondo's corner's all saying, put on the pressure.
You got Kondo Shudi in the red shorts and Mina Grisander in the black shorts.
Right.
This is your main event of the evening, folks. Pick a side and cheer them on.
Right. Looks like Grisander's doing a good job of staying alive. She wants to push that exchange more. She wants to get exchange because maybe she'll get lucky. Maybe she'll land a punch that will drop Kondo.
Yeah.
Or she can do that again, go for that takedown she had success with at the end of the second round.
Instead of answering with a counterpunch each time, but she needs to keep it going.
Yeah, she needs to win.
Yes.
Oh, nice knee from Kondo.
She needs to feel a sense of urgency. Yeah. We're down to 2 minutes in the final round of the main event. Yeah. Pancras 284.
Right. And in situations like this, it's where it's good to have a variety of attacks, a variety of strategies in case one doesn't work out. So we see Grisana going for the same setup and takedown attempt, but it's the third shot in. Kondo knows what's going to happen.
She needs to be careful here. Making that space just leaves her open to get kneed.
Right. Yeah. Kondo doing a good job bullying Grisana, putting her against the cage.
Yep. Kondo looking for that trip for a second.
Mm-hmm. Referee calling for action. Could see a possible break soon. Kondo looking pretty content just to hold against cage. She may try to drop down, go for that double leg takedown. The problem is, you gotta be careful about opening your neck up. Yeah, it's good. She got her hands.
She gotta watch out for that guillotine.
Nice takedown, though.
Sanders got Kondo in a good position to choke her.
Right.
She's got that knee in there pushing her back.
Right.
That adds pressure to the neck.
Right. She did a good job, though, trying to avoid that by passing the guard and getting to side mount. Short time left.
Under a minute to go.
Wow. Shooty's
bulldog choking.
Bulldog choke indeed.
Yeah.
Drop, see if he drops some elbows. And she does.
Little short elbows are killers.
To the already tenderized face of Grisana. Oh my goodness.
Meat tenderized. Yeah.
This is brutal. Wow. Yeah. Big hammer fist in the final seconds of the match.
Six. The bell rung, and that is the end of that fight.
Yeah. Hard fought win, I think, from Shuri Kondo.
Yeah, that was her hardest opponent to date.
I think so.
Look at that, she's got her hips low, and she starts raining down those little hammer fists.
Really good pressure.
Yeah, and then here comes those little elbows. Those are the ones that cut you up.
Yes.
Yeah.
A well-deserved drink at the end of her fight.
Just a sip of water. Here comes Cassandra. All right, your winner for proceedings, main event, Shuri Kondo. All three judges give her the win. She walks away with another W, undefeated.
Very impressive win. Impressive win.
Ending Dr. Sanders' fight streak.
That's right. But nothing to be embarrassed about on Grisana's side.
Absolutely.
She fought very, very hard. And wish her best of luck in her championship match. You say that she might be having
coming up next, right?
Yes.
All right, your winner is Shuri Kondo. Excellent job. Okay.
I finished my fight. I'm so relieved. Thank you very much. I was so happy to be able to fight at the main event for Pancras. Thank you, CEO Sakai,
Don,
and everybody here. I'm going to go home to Boss Jim and keep working hard. Thank you for everything, everybody, for cheering me on and coming to support me. After this win, I feel like I'm getting closer to my dream. I'm getting there step by step. Closer by closer.
応援の方よろしくお願いします。ありがとう。
please continue to support me. Thank you so much, everybody.
All right, so the judges, all three judges gave Shuri Kondo the win, and she won that in a spectacular fashion.
Right.
Really amazing. Really amazing. You know, those little short elbows.
Yeah. You can really see, like, the breadth of her time, of her abilities. Not just the ground game, the wrestling in the previous fights. You could see her really dominating, like, stand-up game as well.